I've heard you guys loud and clear in my comments and on Twitter, and now that sunsetting is gone, or at least paused until they figure out a new solution, we need to talk about your vault. If it's anything like mine, it's filled to the brim with armor pieces that you're probably never going to use. So let's talk about important armor stats for each class and how to filter out the junk using Destiny Item Manager. Then at the end of the video, we're going to make a build and save it as a dim loadout for future use. So first, let's talk about the anatomy of an armor piece in case you are new to Destiny 2. There are 6 armor stats: mobility, which increases your movement speed and maximum jump height, resilience, which increases the amount of damage you can take before dying, recovery, which increases the speed at which you regain lost health, discipline, which decreases the cooldown time of your grenades, intellect, which reduces the cooldown time of your super ability, and strength, which decreases the cooldown time of your melee ability. Your class ability is also tied to one of these stats. For Hunter, it's mobility, so your dodge is tied to your mobility stat. For Titan, your shield is tied to your resilience stat. And for Warlock, your rift is tied to your recovery stat. The higher your stats, the lower your cooldown is going to be for those abilities like your grenade, super, and melee. For these 6 armor stats, you're only going to see a change in your cooldown once you go up to the next tier. So if your discipline stat is at 59, shown here on my Hunter, that's actually a tier 5, and the cooldown is not going to go down until you hit 60 total stats in discipline. Which is why you always want to try to get flat tiers on all of your stats so that you don't waste any points. The total stat range that you can find on pieces in the wild is gonna range anywhere from 46 all the way up to about 70, and exotics are most likely gonna drop with higher than average stats than most of your legendary gear, and you wanna hold on to those exotics if you get good rolls, because when you pull them out of your collections, it's gonna be a set roll and not the random rolls that you find in the wild or from Xur. You can acquire this high stat armor from different sources in game, like Prime Engrams, which includes those 8 bounties that you can do weekly from Shax, Zavala, and Drifter. In raids, trials, Iron Banner, Empire Hunts at higher difficulties if you have the Sabotage perk unlocked with Varix, from dungeons like Prophecy, Shattered Throne, and Pit of Heresy. Pit of Heresy is guaranteed to drop you an armor piece that has 2 spiky stats, meaning 2 of them are going to be above 16. And then depending on the season, some activities are going to reward high stat armor, like this season we have the Expunge mission. Also keep in mind, when you masterwork an armor piece by increasing the energy up to 10, you're going to be adding +2 to each of the 6 stats. So what makes a good armor piece? For endgame activities and ultimate min-maxing, you're going to want to focus on 2 to 3 armor stats. This is going to help you dramatically reduce your cooldowns and increase your DPS. This is better than an even split across the board into all your stats, because depending on your build, you're going to want to focus in one stat or the other, and this won't really be boosting anything. It's just kind of status quo. The armor stats that you choose are going to vary based on your class and your build, but in general, here's what I go for. On the Hunter, you want to look for mobility, recovery, intellect, and discipline. Discipline is great for subclasses like Bottom Tree Nightstalker or when you're in PvP to be able to throw a lot more grenades. Strength isn't really important on Hunter at all due to the Gambler's Dodge, where you get your melee back if you dodge near enemies. Then for Warlock, recovery, intellect, and discipline. Titans, recovery, intellect, and discipline. Or you could also look for strength on Titan if you're going for a specific melee build. You probably noticed that I didn't choose resilience for any class, even for Titan, which resilience governs the cooldown of your barrier. But in my experience, resilience isn't really going to do much to keep you alive in endgame PvE activities. Each resilience tier is going to give you about 1-2% damage resistance, but in comparison to 1 concussive dampener mod on your chest piece, that's going to give you 15% damage resistance against AoE type damage, so like boomer shots, Atheon splash damage, etc. So with that example, you can see why I would choose a mod over spending my armor stats in resilience. You can also add a second mod to your chest, and you can switch it up depending on the activity. So you can put sniper resistance, melee resistance, different elemental resistances, which give around 5%, I think. So there's a lot more freedom to tailor your damage resistance with the chest mods instead of going into a flat shield resistance. In PvP, resilience can help you tank damage from other players in certain scenarios, and for most of the tests that I've seen, 60 resilience will allow you to tank most of them, like the two-shot Thorn kill. But I usually run around with like 40 to 50 in PvP, and I do pretty alright. I am definitely not a top tier PvP player, but I like to think I'm somewhere in the middle, and I don't really notice any difference in performance when I run higher resilience versus lower. The other reason why I prioritize recovery and intellect is that those armor mods cost the most to slot into your armor. At 4 and 5, they take away precious energy that you could be using for other mods like reserves mods, charge with light, warmind, all that good stuff. Mobility, resilience, discipline, and strength mods all cost 3 energy, so you can stack those up at a lower cost if you need to make up some tiers in those stats. We can also use the new plus 5 mods to top off any stats that aren't flat, and those are only going to cost us 1 or 2. But again, recovery and intellect are going to cost more even with the plus 5 mods. A final note about armor stats is that stasis can actually add stat points depending on your fragments, so keep that in mind when you create your build if you're looking at it while stasis is on and you're using any of those fragments with the bonus stats. Or you create a build with a couple stats that have 100 and then you move to stasis and it goes up to 110. Well, now you have 10 wasted stat points. All right, now that you have all that information, let's use it to clean out our vault. For this, we're gonna be using DestinyItemManager.com. DIM is a third-party browser app that helps you organize your inventory, create loadouts, view vendors, bounties, and so much more. There are many other apps out there. If you want a list of my top ones, let me know, but DIM is a must-use app if you play Destiny. I have many other videos on my channel on the many facets of DIM, so if you want to check that out, I will leave a link in the description. All right, so here we are on beta.destinyitemmanager.com, which is their beta version, which you can try out. Sometimes you get access to features that they're working on. But the first thing that we're going to want to do, and this is especially important if you guys are still leveling up your power, as you can see up here, I'm already 1320, so I don't have to worry too much, but I'm still holding on to some pieces of gear that I want to infuse. So what you're going to want to do is go to this gear icon here in the top right, and we're going to pull this power level up to the top like this so that it sorts by power level. And then I'm going to go through and mark whatever I want to infuse so that I don't have to worry about accidentally deleting it because it has bad stats. So for example, I already have these 1320 pieces marked for infusion, but basically you want to mark anything that you want to infuse so that you don't mistake it for just a bad piece of armor and get rid of it. And to mark something for infusion, you're just going to click on it, go to tag item, and then scroll down to infuse, and that is it. You are good to go. You can see the little lightning bolt there. So we're going to go ahead and go back to that gear icon and then pull the power level back down. The next thing we're going to do in the settings screen here is scroll down to custom total. Now this is a way for you to tell DIM which stats you're most interested in on each class. Now obviously you could get rid of discipline on here if you wanted to. You just have to click it and it will take it away and add it back in. So now that we're back on the inventory screen, I want to show you guys something that you can do quickly to identify any super low items that you want to get rid of immediately. What we're going to put up here in the top is base stat, and you can see once you start typing, it's going to try and autofill for you so you don't have to remember all of these filters. But we're actually going to put total and then colon again, and then we're going to do less than 58, and this is going to show us all of our armor that is less than a total stat of 58. This is where my threshold is for what I would consider high stat armor. It may be different for you, but we're also going to go in and look at all these pieces to see if they have really high stats in anything that we want. So we've got a 1320 chest here with resilience and strength. That's going to be an infuse for me, dog. And then the Lightkin vest is a 52 roll. That's definite junk. And the Red Moon vest is a 48. Yikes, super low. That's definitely junk. So I'm going to drag this over to my hunter. There it is right there, and we're going to open this up. And then when I look in dim, I can see that we mark this as infusion. This one we want to get rid of for sure. And also this one. So you can kind of compare to dim and make sure you have the right pieces. You can also move everything else to your vault and only put the junk pieces on your character if you're afraid that you're going to dismantle something that you want. But that is how you go about actually getting rid of them. You do have to delete them in the game and not in dim. And then we can go back to dim here and we can actually hit the refresh at the top and it's going to update to show that we removed those chess pieces. So from here, we have a couple options. Option number one is something that was actually shared in my Discord. So big thank you to Ollie for sharing this. You guys can get a hold of this in my Discord. I'll make sure to pin it. There's a link down in the description. But basically this long list right here is going to filter out all the good armor and highlight the bad armor that you may want to take a look at and get rid of. It explains at the top that this is optimized for creating builds with double 100 stats. So all you need to do is copy and paste everything from this notepad, press enter, and there you go. And now dim is highlighting any pieces that are quote unquote bad. So you want to take a look at these pieces one by one and make sure it's something that you wouldn't mind getting rid of. The other way you can use dim to organize your armor is to go to the organizer tab up here at the top. If we click on that and then we click on the class that we want to look at, and we can see all of our armor pieces separately. And then to filter out the exotics, we just need to hold shift on our keyboard, click on legendary, and it will get rid of that for us. It's also going to put is legendary up here in the search bar, which you can do as well. So now that we've got all 16 of our legendary helmets, we're actually going to click on the custom total right here, and it's going to sort by custom total. So you can scroll down and see what has the lowest custom total. And if these columns aren't set up for you guys here, you can go to enabled columns and turn off and on whichever ones you want. You can get even more granular if you want and click on certain stats to see if you have any armor pieces that are pretty similar. I find that helpful because a lot of times I'll have armor pieces that are extremely similar and I don't even realize it. All right, so the last thing I wanted to show you guys is the loadout optimizer. Real quick, we're gonna create a PvP loadout and save it in dim, which is gonna allow us to equip these items when we're in orbit ready to play PvP. So the first thing you wanna do when you're creating a loadout is select the exotic that you want to build around, because you're always going to be building around an exotic armor piece. For this one, we're going to select Wormhusk Crown. Dodging gives a small health and shield bump. This is a great PvP piece. And when you select this exotic, it's actually going to choose from any of your Wormhusks. So if you do have duplicates, the next thing you're going to want to do is either turn on or off assume masterwork stats. If this is something that you're building and you're going to be masterworking all of the pieces of armor, then go ahead and turn this on. If you toggle it off, it's going to just look at what you have already. So see how it's pulling up a lot of the pieces that I've already masterworked because they have higher stats. But for this case, we're going to turn this on to see what we can achieve if we masterwork everything. So you can drag and drop these stats right here to prioritize them. So with Wormhusk, we really want our dodge up as much as possible. So we're going to put that in the priority one, and then recovery, then discipline, intellect, and then strength we don't really care about. So we're going to ignore, and resilience for now, we're going to ignore as well. The next thing that I like to do is put powerful friends on, because I know I always want to use it on my hunter, especially in PvP. This is going to give us a 20 boost to mobility, and you can see here it's giving us up to 9 mobility, 94 to be exact. And we know we want to bump up our recovery to at least 8, so let's go ahead and do that. And then discipline to at least 8 would be great as well. So now we're getting some pretty good stats here, 10 recovery, 9 discipline, which is great, but we only have 5 mobility. However, we do have 5 slots to put armor stats in. You can play around with it a little bit and move these stats around and see what we can get. So here we have 7 mobility, 9 recovery, and 8 discipline. I'm okay with 9 recovery if it means we can get up to max discipline. And here we could put 2 mobility mods, a discipline mod, and have triple 9s here. Our resilience is extremely low though, so we may want to keep a couple mods just for resilience. But let's include resilience again and go up to 2. And then we can go back in to select mods and put on a couple of mobility mods. And so now we're at 8 mobility, 8 recovery, 9 discipline, and 3 resilience. So we're going to go ahead and add a couple resilience mods. Let's go up to 9 mobility, and then we're going to actually add a recovery mod as well. And there we go. There is an awesome PvP build using the Wormhusk Crown. We've got 9 mobility, 9 recovery, 9 discipline, and 4 resilience, which is fine for me in PvP. So we're going to save the loadout. So if you click save your loadout, you can rename it to Wormhusk PvP. It's going to show you your stats without the mods on, and then it'll list out the mods down here. Now you're going to have to apply these mods in game, so make sure you do that. But we're going to go ahead and save that. And then when you go back to your inventory screen, you can click on these three dots right here. So as you can see, we've got the Wormhusk PvP loadout right here. So we're going to go ahead and click on it. And you can see my character change before your very eyes into the loadout that we just created. Of course, we'd have to masterwork everything and put the correct mods on, but it makes it so much easier when you want to switch to different loadouts. So for instance, here I can put my shards build back on, and as you can see, there it is. I didn't even have to touch my game at all. It just put everything on. Easy peasy to create a loadout, makes it really awesome when you want to switch between different activities. And that is it, guys. Sorry for such a long video, but I wanted to update you on all this armor stuff because I see you guys commenting all the time, not knowing what to keep, what to get rid of, how to create a build, and know what to masterwork. So I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to give it a like and subscribe if you haven't already, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye.